need my permission.
Okay, students, we are starting with self-management today. It is interesting to note that the art of self-management has been introduced as a major concept in your employability skills. And management of self is not only required in the required by you as a student, it is required by all the professionals, whichever fields they may be working, maybe in the field of marketing, it could be in the field of production, it could be in the field of sales, or it could be human resource development, finance, etc. Various, all management requires self-management. The basic, you know, the essence of this particular skill is to teach you the art of managing oneself for a better management of the workplace. So what is a self-management skill? A self-management skill are the abilities that allow the people to control their thoughts, feelings, and actions. If you have a strong self-management skill, you are able to set the goals and take the initiative to achieve them. So you have some good self-management skills here. Number one is the interpersonal skills. The skills that we require in the terms of interpersonal attraction, interpersonal communication. Because, you know, there is some kind of, you know, one person develops an affiliation for the other. So automatically he develops communication skills. So that is interpersonal skills. In the field of generating, you also need skills in productivity. That is to increase the productivity of the enterprise. Then you also need to have the skill of taking initiative. Initiative, as you know, is taking the first step forward, right? For example, you come forth and you help any person or maybe your boss. Okay, sir, may I just calculate the figures for you this time, that how many people have been able to achieve their target? So you are taking an initiative. Confidence level. Your confidence level is immensely important. That is your skill in self-management. So manage yourself with style, with a good confidence level. You should be having the analytical and critical thinking skills. You should be able to analyze the things, come to a conclusion, and always take the lessons of your life as a lifelong experience, as a lifelong learning. Skills of communication and interpersonal skills, they go hand in hand. Resilience is the ability to bounce back when you are stressful. That is called resilience. You should have these feelings. I think, I can, I have, and I am. These are the three principles of resilience. I can do it, I have the capability of to do it, and I am a fully functioning individual. I have all the resources to accomplish my goals. You should be flexible and honest. Flexible means do not be rigid. Be open to ideas. Take new ideas. Take suggestions from people. So a good manager is a person who takes suggestions from people and is able to implement them. And also you should be having a problem solving skill. Whatever problems your employees are facing, you should be also responsible for solving those problems. Plus any kind of solutions you should be able to work out on the problems. So for that, you need to have an in-depth understanding of what you are doing. Now, in this case, I would like to highlight the concept of motivation. Motivation is a concept that basically kickstarts self-management. So motivation, as you have already learned, in your other academic subjects, like in business studies, it is a process that guides the individual towards a goal-directed behavior. All right, it initiates the individual to move towards the goals, and it stimulates the individual, you know, to get driven in order to achieve that particular goal. So it involves the biological, emotional, social, and cognitive forces that activate behavior. Today, we are going to focus not only on motivation, but also self-motivation. What is exactly self-motivation? Motivating oneself. That is the basic idea behind self-motivation. As we just pointed out, that motivation has been defined as the drive which is required to engage in goal-directed behavior or goal-oriented behavior. It is an inner urge to do something, and self-motivation is the ability to do what needs to be done without the influence of trust from the other people or situations. You don't do something because a teacher is telling you or the parents are telling you. It doesn't happen in all the circumstances. You are self-motivated. So self-motivation gives you that force, that gives you the push to go on. It is the internal drive to achieve, to produce, to develop, and keep moving forward. When you think you are ready to quit something, or you just don't know how to start, it is your self-motivation that pushes you forward. You practice righteousness regarding what needs to be accomplished, what shall be done. And a self-motivated person always is full of high spirits and full of positivity. That is the best part of self-motivation. So as I just told you, self-motivation has certain characteristics, and it is important because it gives you positive energy, number one. Number two, it helps you to hit the bullseye, that is to achieve your target. Plus, it gives you that spirit to move on. You get activated, you are persistent, you are perseverant, right? You need know the intensity, that why you have to achieve that particular goal, and thus you are active all the time. Motivation is actually something that keeps you active and on your toes in your life. Now, another thing is that motivation affects your cognitive processes. What are cognitive processes? Cognitive processes, my dear students, are the mental faculties or the mental processes which help you to learn things, memorize things, perceive things, right? Remember things, or all what you do when you are studying, problem solving, analyzing, decision making, passing a judgment, right? So you are able to accomplish all the tasks just because you have very powerful cognitive activity, right? So this is the reason that motivation, self-motivation is very, very important. So with this, I would like to close this particular session on self-motivation. In the next class, I will teach you regarding the types of motives.